Google is about to reveal its breakthrough AI chatbot for search, so will it overthrow ChatGPT? Microsoft's use of OpenAI's GPT-4 was briefly seen by Bing search engine users. Next to the search button, a chatbot button was screen captured that leads to an information page about the new chat interface, which lets users ask questions and receive AI-generated responses with source citations. Microsoft will likely promote the service on the homepage of the standard search, but it still encourages users to fact-check and provide feedback for AI improvement. Meanwhile, Google has faced increasing pressure to respond to OpenAI's ChatGPT, as now more than 100 million people use it per month, and as a result of the competition, Google has now publicly announced that it's about to launch AI products for search and user interaction, APIs for developers, a business application, and its own cloud platform. More specifically, Google has highlighted two of its major language models called Palm and Lambda, which Google considers to be the largest and most advanced AI models available in the world. Furthermore, Google has announced that these models will be launched in the near future, with Lambda set to be released first, which is a direct human interaction model and a serious threat to ChatGPT. On top of this, Google intends to incorporate its language models into Google Search soon, allowing the AI systems to enhance current search methods in experimental and innovative ways beyond the ability of ChatGPT. On February 8 at 8:30 ET, Google will stream an event focused on search, maps, and related topics on YouTube, and according to an invitation via The Verge, Google will also demonstrate how AI is transforming the way people search for, discover, and interact with information, making search more natural and intuitive than ever before. Most interestingly, it's said that Google is internally testing a chatbot called Apprentice Bard, which is based on its Lambda model and is similar to ChatGPT. It works by letting the user type a question or text and receive a direct answer, but the breakthrough of Apprentice Bard in contrast to ChatGPT is its ability to respond to current requests. The major shortfall of ChatGPT is that its memory only extends to 2021, which is when its GPT 3.5 training data ended. Google's Lambda is also reportedly better at performing mathematical tasks, and Google is experimenting with alternative search and search result pages. In one version, a language model will suggest questions under the search box, which could initiate an AI dialogue as a chat feature to replace the current "I'm feeling lucky" search option. When a user types in a query, AI-generated answers will appear in a separate box that can lead to further questions and answers related to the topic. Below this chatbot component, the traditional search results will appear as normal, but it's still uncertain if this implementation will come to fruition, despite the expectation that Google is planning to launch up to 20 new AI products along with this chatbot-based search. An estimate based on familiar web data suggests that approximately 100 million individuals utilized ChatGPT in January, making it the fastest-growing online platform in history. And although it's not directly competing with Google, because information search is only one aspect of it, some people already believe that the future of search may be in the direction of chatbots or similar applications. Even if the hypothesis about search proves to be incorrect, ChatGPT's significant user base will disrupt other technology firms, and with Microsoft's support, it's now taking over a potential growth market. As this technology ripens, competitors are gathering, such as with Meta also intending to enter the chatbot race. With continuous breakthroughs coming from artificial intelligence in the area of chatbots, large language models are steadily pushing the envelope, and now a new text-to-image art generator called Bluewillow AI is gaining traction while seemingly throwing a wrench in Midjourney's business model. All because Bluewillow is completely free and allows anyone to generate amazing art and more, without the user needing any digital art experience or skill. In just a few weeks, Bluewillow has already amassed a community surpassing 100,000 users. To get started, users can simply join the Discord community and experiment with prompts to generate their AI art by typing out an image description in one of the newbie channels, which produces 4 images at a time. This looks to be a step into the future of art, as community members can then download the results for their personal use, which resemble professional digital art pieces that can even be photorealistic. And speaking of the future of art, there's a company based out of Manhattan called Masterworks that is pioneering the democratization of blue-chip art using proprietary data-driven technology. Their business model has not only unlocked this historically exclusive asset class and brought it to the masses through their white glove process, but has materialized unheard of net returns to their investors, beating the S&P 500 time and time again. The Masterworks process starts off with buying an expensive art piece, then breaking it into affordable shares, and finally listing it on the platform. You can read all the offering circulars at the SEC database linked in the description. This isn't some crypto or NFT at all, but instead it's actual fine art from artists like Picasso and Banksy, and the numbers don't lie, as you don't have to be an art expert to see that the S&P pales in comparison to Masterworks' last 11 returns. Because of these returns, Masterworks has made a name for itself, appearing on CNBC, Forbes, CNN, the New York Stock Exchange, and all over the news. With a world-class research team dedicated to finding art pieces that they believe will maximize the best returns for their customers, Masterworks has figured out how to utilize the advent of technology and modernize an age-old process. Because more and more people look to hedge against their traditional portfolio and increase their upside this year, Masterworks has been seeing unprecedented demand. If you want to join the growing 600,000 user base, you're in luck, as usually there is a waitlist to join. But we were offered the opportunity to give our subscribers an exclusive pass to cut the waitlist and jump on the new offerings they have before anyone else, so click the link below before offerings sell out. But visual art isn't the only domain that is being affected by breakthroughs in technology, as researchers have presented Audio LDM, a stunning text-to-audio system that utilizes a latent space and contrastive language audio pre-training latents to learn continuous audio representations. Here are some examples of single text prompts that created the following audio clips. The contrastive language audio pre-training models provide text embedding as a condition, while the latent diffusion models, known as LDNs, learn the audio embeddings. Audio LDN offers improved generation quality and computational efficiency by learning latent audio representations without modeling cross-modal relationships. It achieves state-of-the-art text-to-audio performance as measured by objective and subjective metrics and can perform various text-guided audio manipulations without additional training. Most impressively, Audio LDN was trained on audio caps using a single GPU.